out yet another time on our online learning platform. And I blame my humble self, Emmanuel Nanman. And at this point in time, we'll be looking at the subject home economics. And under home economics, we'll be discussing the topic care of the eye. As you all know, we've been looking at the series care of the sense organs. And we've looked at care of the ear and care of the nose. And at this point in time, we want to look at the care of the eye. We have five sense organs. They are the skin, the eye, the nose, the tongue, and the ear. So at this point in time, we'll look at care of the eye. Now, what is the eye? The eye is the sense organ of sight. I take that again. I said the eye is the sense organ of sight. That means we use the ear for the eyes rather for seeing. We use the eye for seeing. Now, having known what the eye is very important to us due to the fact that we see things with our eyes. As it is now, you are watching this video with your eye. You are able to see me and hear my voice due to the aid of your eye and your ear. Now, since the eye is very important to us as humans, therefore we need to do what? Take adequate care of the eye to avoid it being affected by some organs that may not be good to us. Of course, you know there are blind people in town and they are not finding it easy going around places. So you and I that can see needs to take adequate care of our eyes. Now, the eye is located on our hair, our face, and each human being has two pair of eyes. Now, having established the fact that the eye is the organ for sight, and we've seen how important the eye is, let's quickly look at the care of the eye. How do we take care of the eye? The first and paramount thing we need to do as students or pupils is to always take care of our eyes, because without the eye, we cannot read. Now, if you want to read, what do you do? How do you read? When the place is dark, how do you read? You endeavor to make sure you read under a bright and clear light, because reading under a dull light will affect the visibility or the usage of your eye, the performance of your eyes, that is to say. Now, two, always use clean handkerchief to rub your eyes, not to use your dirty hands to rub your eyes, okay? Because dirt affects the performance of the eye. And three, keep your eyes away from sharp objects like pin, knife, sand, and smoke. All these are things that can affect the performance of your eyes. Now, let's quickly turn our attention and look at dangers associated to not taking good care of our eyes. If that is to say, if we don't take care of our eyes, what happens? The following are the result or the consequence of not taking adequate care of your eyes. One, when the eye is not cared for, it causes eye problems or defects. Okay, that is when eye is not cared for, it causes eye problems or defects. Defects are also problems associated with something. Okay, so secondly, eye problem can be short sight. Okay, that is an example of a person suffering from short sight is inability of a boy or a girl to see the board from a distance. If you want to copy a note on the board, you will not be able to see from a distance until he or she comes closer to the board before he or she is able to copy what is written on the board. Now, the eyes become red when we allow sand and smoke to enter into it. Okay, the eyes become red when we allow sand or smoke to come into it. Yeah, it will defect or make the eye not to perform at its maximum. There are so many people around us suffering from eye problems, and there are some that even use eyeglasses due to the fact that they are not able to see clearly with their natural eyes and until they use an enhancement device like the glasses. So you and I know the importance of keeping our eyes safe. So you do well. With this, I want to appreciate you for listening to this lesson. and you below the video you get your notes, and I would like to encourage you to copy the notes and then drop your questions if where you don't understand. So thank you, and make sure you stay safe and take care of your eye.